Pogo, you bound.
Help Pogo escape from the evil research laboratory where the mean old scientist genetically altered him.
Uh-oh, the pharmaceutical scientist is going to get you, Pogo.
Here you go, Pogo. Have a gold coin.
Good thing Pogo has a banana cannon. Those nasty scientists deserve to die. Now get the shampoo manufacturers before they squirt it in your eye.
Here you go, Pogo. Have a diamond.
You'll guide Pogo through tons of fun adventures, including saving Timmy, who fell down the well.
Help! Here you go, Pogo. Have a big watch.
Rescue a cat out of that tree with your banana cannon, Pogo. Idiot gamer called Pogo the best spring in the Simian game since bouncing bananas. Buy the game Pogo the Monkey today. Right, Pogo? And coming soon, Pogo the Monkey card game, Pogo the Monkey plastic car covers. For the dad who has everything, why not a Pogo the Monkey tie and sports jacket? For the lady in your life, why not Pogo the Monkey chocolates and hygiene products so she smells like a real monkey? And for kids, a life-size, living, breathing, springing monkey. All available at PogoTheMonkey.com.
Liberty City, this is your talk radio show, Chatterbox, where your opinion matters. Let's go to the phones. Hello, caller, you're on Chatterbox.
Hey, you're Red Possum. Good evening.
I really can't say I have it.
Well, you're on track sometimes. Hey, man, it's Goody, Possum, Rasson, even Super Meat. It's pretty good.
Do you have anything else to say, or...?
Pigeons are good, too. Sometimes... they come with notes attached. It's like a fortune cookie with wings. Squirrels are not so good. They taste like goldfish. Meat is real stringy. You know what I mean?
Actually, I can't say that I do. But if I did eat too much squirrel and put on a few extra pounds, I'd use the Dormatron. Unlike those other exercise machines that require you to be awake, the Dormatron actually exercises you overnight. Let's learn a little bit more about it.
I've tried everything, and I just couldn't keep those extra 200 pounds off. It started to affect my marriage.
She was too big for me, and I'll sleep with anything.
The Abdometrix, the Thiasize, it's on me stapling. I've had my mouth sewn up, my hands chopped off. You name it, I've tried it.
Yeah, except for exercising and eating right, Balky.
That's right, honey. Then I found the Dormatron. Using a new technology called Biorhythmic Subconscious Gymnastics, the Dormatron exercises you while you sleep. Just strap in your arms and legs, put on the Dormatron headset, then wrap yourself in a special high-voltage electric blanket. Turn it on to 11 and burn those pounds away while you have a relaxing night's sleep. Now that I've lost 280 pounds, my husband's all mine again.
That's right, honey. No more escort services for me.
Don't be fat a day longer than you have to. Remember, being fat can even ruin a romantic cruise. Call Dormatron now at 1-800-SLEEP-OFF-LARG or visit www.sleepofflarg.com and sleep your way to a thinner, happier you.
I'm a marketing manager who lives in the suburbs and commutes to work on the highway. I live alone, so of course I needed a car that could seat 12 and is equipped to drive across Arctic country. It just makes me feel better.
The new My Boxer Monstrosity. Mine is bigger.
Oh, that's a good commercial. I love commercials, don't you? This is Chatterbox. We are taking your calls right now. Hello, caller. You are on the air.
Hi, Lazlo. Is that your real name?
Of course it's my real name.
Are you Hungarian?
No, I'm from upstate.
Are you sure that's not a fake radio name like Timmy or Bobo? I thought all those radio people had fake names.
Do you have a question or you just want to sit here and talk all day about my name?
No, that's it. Love to go, Lazlo. Or Mark. Or Don. Or Bentley. Whatever your name is.
Alright, next caller, you're on Chatterbox. What is on your mind?
Turnips. Root vegetables. Albino carrots as they're known back home.
Okay, here's the deal. This isn't Gardening with Maurice. That's on later.
No, he got taken off the air. He lied, I know he did. I've been trying to make a hybrid of a peach and a Pekingese midget fight bitch for the last 2 years. and it is impossible. Impossible, I tell you.
Okay, and speaking of impossible, Jane from Cedar Grove is on the line, and she wants to talk about how difficult it is being a parent today. Hello, Jane.
Hi, Laszlo. I love the show. I'm a first-time caller. I wanted to say something about these video games. They are warping our kids' minds. My son's dog, Hugo, got hit by a truck, and he said, Mommy, Mommy, where's the reset button? Kids these days, they think life is a game. Well, it's not a game, Laszlo. It is very, very true. I let my kids play video games, and now he runs around the house looking for gold coins.
Going for a little ride into Epburn Heights. Kill me some filthy Diablo boo-boo spin botting up me lady Queen Lizzie. You do the driving and the shooting and the dallying a boot. We'll make sure you don't get cold feet. Here, you'll need a piece.
Laughing vampires dance! Feel the boot.
Let's drive.
All around.
How's that?
All right, it's evil, dude. And toothpaste, they use it to control us. Why do you think all the commercials tell you to brush it twice a day? I've read books.
And what book have you been reading that tells you that toothpaste is evil?
Dentures, the Devil, and the Great Cavity Cover-Up by J. Bill Higginbottom. If you've seen what I've seen, and if you've heard what I've heard, you'd never brush your teeth again.
I suppose you're one of those people that says that diet soda makes you go crazy later in life.
I told you before, man. Don't mock me. My cash will pay your salary, man.
Sir, this is a commercial radio station owned by Love Media. Advertising revenue pays my salary. And on that note, it's been 2 full minutes since a commercial. But I'd like to say, if anyone else is stressed, might I recommend Equinox from Zaibatsu Pharmaceuticals? We'll be back after these important messages.
Hello.
I used to be concerned and nervous about the future. Sometimes I'd get scared before an important event such as childbirth or a family funeral. Hey, sometimes you need a little help navigating life's trouble spots. That's when I discovered Equinox.
After the divorce and losing little Tommy, Ike was getting me down. I couldn't focus on anything. After trying Equinox, I've been employee of the month 3 times in a row.
I used to fall unconscious for hours at a time. Now with Equinox, I never need to sleep.
Equinox is new from Zaibatsu Pharmaceuticals. Ask your doctor about Equinox today.
Softening life's harsh realities.
Tonight, the TV event that will make history, Liberty City Survivor. This takes reality TV to a whole new level. We'll take 20 recently paroled guys, equip them with grenades.
Excuse me, some filthy Diablo. Remember, you went this to the end, man. Hold your corner.
Sandwich at the Happy Blimp, and all of a sudden these guys crashed through the window and started shooting at each other. I was so excited, I didn't even notice I'd been hit. After that, I was hooked on Liberty City Survivor. I'm watching every day in the hospital.
The game doesn't end until there's only one man left standing. Tune in nightly or watch the 24-hour live webcast. Liberty City Survivor. Natural selection has come home.
Alright, we're back from Chatterbox. Call us on the Chatter line to tell us what's on your mind. Line 4, you're on Chatterbox. What's on your mind?
Liberty City Cox rule!
Ah, that's lovely, thanks. Next caller, you're on Chatterbox.
And last time, so lovely with crap. Everyone knows I'm a fan.
Okay, great. Another lunatic. Hello, next caller, you are on Chatterbox.
Yeah, you were talking about short guys and attitudes. Well, you know, you'd have an attitude too if you couldn't reach the friggin' cheese. World in the grocery store.
Yeah, I mean, sometimes it seems like the whole world's against you. I mean,
you know, we're not talking about you. What kind of egomaniac are you? You got your own show. How about letting other people talk to you? Oh, that's the law. Volta. I think that's what this is, top show. Hey, what's the weather like down there? How's it going, short stuff? Can you get that? Get close. My first dad. Who do you think you are? Short people are people, too.
All right, another award-winning show on Chatterbox. Bring your thoughts on anything. If you have something to say about anything, call now. Hello, caller. You're on Chatterbox.
Dude, that should do it. Now get us back to the yard. Go, 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 now!
Most of all, guns. I had a big wine about guns kill people. Guns don't kill people, death kills people. That's a doctor. Medical fact. You can't die from a bullet. You can't die from cardiac arrest or organ failure or major hemorrhage. A small piece of metal ain't the problem. Besides, I only use my machine gun in the safety of my own home, the car. I ain't hurt nobody. And countries that don't have guns ain't America.
You know, that's a really good point. The countries that don't have guns aren't American. You know, if more people had guns, we'd have less shootings in this country. All right, we're going over here to line two. Hello, caller. You are on Chatterbox.
Yeah, I'd like to say something about taxes.
You mean the Lone Star State?
Oh, taxes. You know, look, taxes are really wrong. My father worked his whole life. He played the lottery. Now the state wants to pay taxes on the money he wins from that stuff. Buy your own lottery ticket. Oh, hey.
Good point. I think that's a lesson to us all. All right. Hello, you are on Chatterbox.
Hello, lads. So I'm a first-time caller. I recently moved to this city from Hampshire, England.
Oh, really? How do you like it? I mean, is it hard to get used to the language? You speak English pretty good.
Oh, thank you, lads. Yes, yes, I do like it here. There's one thing, though, that's very different and rather worrying. When I was a boy in England, I had a nanny. She was very strict, I think.
Yeah, well, I mean, there's excellent child care here in America, you know.
Well, I'm sure. But the thing is, Laszlo, when I was a naughty boy, I would get spanked. Nanny would spank me when I was naughty. And now Freddy needs nanny. But when Freddy's naughty, he needs to get spanked.
Well, there's some child psychologists who probably say that spanking can be harmful to a child's emotional development.
Okay, you're the kind of man we like as friend now. You're Irie man, real shooter.
We're talking about short guys, nannies, taxes, and anything sane you'd like to bring to the party. Hello, you are on Chatterbox.
I want you to steal me some gang car so we can do some naughty thing on our enemy turf. I want me a Mafia Sentinel, a Yakuza Stinger, and a Diablo Inferno so we can hit up any gang in Liberty. Drop them off at the garage in Newport and hear this. They're no use to me, all broke up now.
Sine and cosine are two of the most noble, incredible discoveries of humanity. I mean, the Cartesian coordinate system has an elemental power I find liberating and sexy. I'm not ashamed to say it.
Okay, thanks for calling. Now that we've lost 98% of our audience, let's reward the other 2% with a commercial. When we come back, we'll have a special studio guest. Special because he advertises on this radio station. Remember, it's not a conflict of interest if we own all the radio stations in town. We'll be right back after this message.
In today's fast-paced world, a split second can be the difference between achieving your dreams...
Hey, I just won the Nobel Peace Prize!
...and not.
Oh, wonder brass.
More Americans are realizing if you don't have the latest and greatest technological devices, you will fall behind.
I didn't upgrade my personal organizer, and 2 days later I was diagnosed with a terminal illness.
That's exactly why you should come visit the friendly people at House of Tomorrow, and they'll set you up with all your 21st century technology needs.
I only spent $20,000, and now I can get email in the shower or surf the internet while I'm driving. I was bored stupid at my daughter's recitals and my son's Little League games. Now thanks to House of Tomorrow, I can play wireless head-to-head 3D virtual reality poker literally anywhere.
If it's a flash in the pan technology of absolutely no use to anyone, you can find it at House of Tomorrow. Remember, only technology makes life worth living. House of Tomorrow. We'll upgrade your system, then you can upgrade your life.
And now it is my great pleasure to welcome Fernando Martinez, who it says here is the founder of Fernando's New Beginnings, a revolutionary new way of saving your marriage. Fernando, welcome.
The pleasure is my pleasure. It is an honor to be here. I feel blessed.
Thanks. So, tell me about Fernando's new beginnings.
Truly, Laszlo, it is a miracle, a blessing. It is a revolution in the Irish life. For my people, Harold, it is, how to say, sacred. The bond between the father and the mother. So, for my people, it is the holiest, most sacrosanct thing imaginable, like a church. Yet, for it to be a happy marriage, it must also be like a brothel. The woman, she must be many, many arts, be skilled in making house, cooking, changing the diapers on the babies, and she must also be a whore, a vixen in the bedroom, imaginative, exotic, constantly fresh. It is impossible. You change diapers and then you are a French maid? Fernando thinks not. Fernando knows not.
Well, I mean, you know, it's an age-old problem. I mean, how do you keep the excitement in a marriage?
Excitement, exactly. Passion, danger. How, Laszlo? How? Tell me how, and I give you a big, big kiss. Like I give a woman. But I am not going to give you a big kiss. Not a kiss like I give a woman or even a donkey. Because you do not know.
Well, I mean, in this case, ignorance kind of seems like bliss. I wasn't really up for kissing on air, I mean.
Why not, Laszlo? Am I not attractive? Am I not irresistible even to you? Well, no matter. Why all this talking about kissing?
I mean, you brought it up.
No, my friend. If a man was born an angel, maybe impossible. But a man is born a man. And a man with knees. He needs a woman to tuck his babies into the bed. But for his bed, he needs something else. Something magical.
So he starts flirting with the secretary, takes her out for a drink. One thing leads to another, and before you know it, he's found all kinds of uses for the office furniture.
Exactly that. I know what you are like. A man who has needs, but an idiot, and I can save you, and I can save your marriage.
My marriage doesn't need saving.
Hey, you are the one mentioning the pretty assistant and the office furniture and the I got Amma, my friend. Listen, Laszlo, listen.
No,
marriage is a present from me, though, but you are a man. I think we see by now you are... diapers and a dirty panties and a scrubby brush and who knows what else. He's not thinking marriage bank. He's thinking about, well, you're thinking about your pretty assistant. We already know that, don't we?
Go on.
But Laszlo, what if you act on your fantasy for your little secretary because you were started to realize? Yeah, smiling. What then, my friend? What then?
I get a sexual harassment suit.
If you are lucky, but you more likely, your marriage is ruined. Your sweetheart, she hates you. Your pretty secretary, she wants you to be her man. You back into square one. My friend, you and 1,000 men like you. For me, once it was so. But then one day, I was driving my car, and I realized, Fernando, you are blessed. You are a miracle. 1,000 miracles rolled into one. You saved the marriage. And saved the man. You don't put the marriage first, and you don't put the man first. Maybe we call it man marriage. Then I think to myself, no, this is a bad name. It sounds really dumb. Then I think we call it Fernando's New Beginnings, because that is what it is, a new beginning.
So how does this work?
It is a miracle, Laszlo, a miracle. But no, not with me. Passion for life. Passion for love. Passion for women. which he can bring home to his wife. Introduce the man to a pleasure he has lost, to the miracles of the world. And truly, the results are remarkable. With my unique counseling, 1,000 marriages have been saved, and 1,000,000 more could be saved every day.
And do the wives know about this?
In their hearts, Laszlo, they know they have been saved.
Okay. We're gonna open it up to the phones. If you've got any questions for Fernando Martinez, Exotic Marriage Guidance Made Easy, ring us now. Hey, oh, cool.
His marriage? It is killing him. Where is... He is ashamed of this wonderful lady who bears him so many love. And he comes to me and he cries, Fernando, save my marriage. I love my wife, even though she is a fat worker. And I say, Jerry, you are a man. It is a man's duty to love.
Hey, Janice, I share your anxiety. The studio kind of forced him on me.
Hey, you watch yourself, mister. And you, Janice, why are you so ugly? Your husband, he don't make you happy.
No, he's an idiot and a jerk.
But he's probably a good daddy, and you sound very pretty.
Do you come from?
I am Latin.
Latin is a big place there, buddy. Where in Latin?
I do not need to listen to these insults. I have pride. I have a calling. Many are called, but you are chosen, my friend. And I was called and chosen to work a miracle.
So, where were you called from, Fernando?
From upstate, okay? You have big money now? And...
Yeah.
Cups to Daddy, come here. Tick-tock, what's on my... Cups to Daddy, come here. Tick-tock, what's on my... Here you go, I got a press brush for delivery. Come here. Here you go, I got a present for you.
Come and we'll send you a cute kitten overnight. PetsOvernight.com, delivering little bundles of love in a box.
Killer bees.
Yes, killer bees. Did you know that if the current migration does continue, we will all be dead in 3 years? Did you want to become a bee supper? I don't. That's why we must act now. Killer bees must be stopped.
I wonder why more people aren't talking about this. I mean, killer bees swarming, it sounds pretty serious.
Ah, but the killer bees are nothing compared to that.
Chatterbox, hello, you're on the air.
Yes. I'd like to say something about these damn people on trains and buses in the city who yammer on and on into their cell phones. I'm really glad to get to hear about what you're having for dinner. What we should do is herd them up, put them on an island. I am the president of a group called Citizens Raging Against Phones.
Crap?
Exactly.
Your organization's called Crap. What kind of moron are you? You want to round people up for using a phone? But you're calling up on a phone to tell the world about it. I mean, how many people are there in this crap?
Citizens are raging against phones, Laszlo.
How many people?
There are three of us.